I recently reviewed the MSI RTX 3060 Ti Aero ITX. The compact size of the card allows us to install it in some smallest PC cases. However, one thing that has been bugging me is the lack of passive fan speed or 0 decibel mode. During idle, the default fan speed was kept at 30% and I could not modify it despite trying different VBIOS from the other 3060 Ti cards. Even though the fan is not so loud, it is still quite audible, so I want to shut it down completely. While the card is very hot during load, having the fan constantly run during idle is unnecessary. Today, I will attempt to connect the GPU fan to my motherboard by using this cable and create a fan curve that stops the fan completely during idle. The fan header is sandwiched between the PCB and the heatsink, which means I have to disassemble the card to access it. To make disassembling the GPU more easy, it is recommended to heat the card up by loading some games with my undervolting profile, 1935MHz at 875mV, the temperature stays around 73 degrees on my test bench. There are 6 screws that I use to hold the heatsink. There's one screw which is covered by an MSI sticker. Before unscrewing, I carefully remove the sealed sticker with a tweezer. I don't really care about it, I just don't want any piece of the sticker stuck in the screw. With the sticker gone, we can go ahead and remove these 6 screws. After that, carefully and slowly twist the heatsink to separate it from the card. The heatsink came out very easily as I just heated it up with Rise of the Tomb Raider. Disconnect the fan from the PCB and we are done. I connected the cable to the GPU fan and plugged it into my motherboard. With fan control software, I set the fan speed to 0% and it did not work. MSI uses a PWM fan with a minimum speed of 1230 RPM. This explains why flashing different VBIOS to this card could not stop the fan. So yeah, this is a completely failed attempt, but we still have something else to do with the GPU. As you can see that I damaged a few thermal pads and I also wanted to see if using good paste could help with temperature. So I grabbed the Thermo Grizzly Cryonaut paste along with the Thermalright Odyssey pad. They both have good thermal conductivity, but there are many users reporting that they receive fake products, so make sure to check the product code on the manufacturer's website before using. I also added thermal pads to these two VRMs at the front of the card, which MSI left out. I put good amount of paste to make sure that the GPU die is fully covered. The thickness of the stock pads is about 1.75mm, but the one I am using is 2mm, so it requires good pressures to squeeze the pads. At first, I thought that the screws alone can flatten the new thermal pads, however, temperature kept going up after a few minutes due to the lack of melting pressure, so I had to reopen the card. As the backplate of this card is just a slim piece of plastic, pushing the PCB against the heatsink is very difficult. I then remove the backplate from the card so that I can press the heatsink and the PCB together without any paste to flatten all the pads. After that, I added new paste and the backplate back to the card. Here is the result. As you already expected, nothing changed, or maybe just 1 degree difference from my observation, from 73 to 71 or 72. The hotspot temp is also the same, around 84 to 85 degrees. Because GDDR6 memory is cool, it doesn't have the temperature sensor, so unfortunately we can't see the memory temp, but I doubt there is any change. Overall, I think MSI already did a very good job on cooling this tiny card, which makes messing around with it unnecessary. One thing that can be done better are the 2 small thermal pads on the R22 VRMs. MSI added pads for the VRM here, but did not have any for these, even though I think it could be unnecessary. Still, having something is better than nothing. So, if you own this card or plan to get one, this GPU is already good to go and you don't have to tinker with it. Even though what I just did was entirely useless, I hope this video can be used as a reference for people who want to disassemble the card for future maintenance. Thank you so much for watching, please subscribe to catch up more videos about this card, and I will see you in the next one. Bye bye.